Saturday evening, Ellis Park Stadium will be the host to a dream team of Manchester United's football legends who are travelling to Johannesburg to play an exhibition match against the Orlando Pirates legends. Former England and Liverpool captain Mark Wright will be part of the management team for the upcoming side from Manchester United, and he's also the director of FC Tours, who provide Legends Tours. And from Orlando Pirates, we're joined by team manager William Okpara. Good to have both of you. Welcome to Morning Live.
Good morning. Morning.
So nice to have you on the program ahead of this match. I mean, this is it's a big thing. I mean, let's begin with you first, Mark. I mean, it's an awesome event to be participating in, but particularly this year, when really it's, you know, Orlando Pirates having a very, very hard time, and so is South Africa with the death of our captain.
Yeah, and we were lucky enough to come with Liverpool last year, yeah. And up in Durban, and it was a great spectacle. 32,000 people turned up, so we started a company to do tours around the world, but we wanted to come back to South Africa because of the way we were treated, you know, and the way that the crowd reacted to us coming out. Yeah. And also we're making it a commemorative game for Senzo, which yeah. would be, you know, and make a percentage of the proceeds to go to his children or to his family. And I think that's a big part of what we wanted to do this time. We're hoping that it beats 32,000 from up in Durban. So it's a challenge to the people of Johannesburg to turn out in their droves to come and support the Pirates or Manchester Legends. So hopefully it'll be a very good spectacle because that's why we wanted to come back.
Absolutely. I mean, you're here for that, is to fill up the stadiums, provide an unbelievable match, as well as some good entertainment, because, I mean, it's not I suppose sports is sports, and the winner, you know, always has that amazing accolade on their side. But I'm sure it's a lot of fun playing a game like this. William, is it? Or is it still that competition out there?
It's a lot of fun. Yeah. Hence, they are here to honor our captain, okay. Our late captain.
Absolutely.
That shows that the stadium is going to be filled with supporters playing in the center of the town, Ellis Park. You're going to see more than 30 to 40,000 people coming to watch this game.
Yeah.
It's not
yeah.
only coming to watch. You know, Pirates were known for creating history. For them to choose Pirates and to choose our captain,
yeah.
it's a great honor. And I'm telling you at this moment, you will never regret, you know, coming to honor our captain.
No.
We love him. Supporters love him. The whole country loves him. Yeah. All Africa and the whole world loves him. So for you to choose to come and honor our captain, you will never regret it. Our supporters will come out in big numbers, and all Africans will be there to witness this game.
Yeah. I think you can tell from the emotion in William that yeah. this is a grand honour that you've bestowed on Pirates for the legends to be here.
Well, you know, he was a great player, and it's a tragic loss to his family, to all his friends, but to the football world as well, yeah. and to all his friends within the Pirate setup. What can you say? It's a tragedy, and so for us to try and give something back and help the people he's left behind, it was a thing that we had to do.
Yeah, good. Well, thank you very much for that on behalf of South Africans for something like that. How are the ticket sales looking? I mean, we're saying between 30 and 40,000 tickets that we're hoping to have sold, but what's it looking like right now?
Looking at 5 to 40,000 supporters.
That's
or more
amazing.
Than.
Yeah. That's fantastic. So we're going to have a full house no exactly. matter what we look. That's a good thing, because, I mean, something like this doesn't happen too often. And the legends that we're going to see. So let's talk about them. Who is going to be a part of the Man United Legends team?
Well, they're all. If you look, when we announce the side and we show the honour list of what they've won in English and British football, is astronomical. Especially the biggest name would be Paul Scholes, because he's only just finished playing.
Yeah.
And his medal roll is incredible. 11 Premier League titles. Which is incredible, you know, European Cups, you know, Super Cups, Intercontinental Cups, UEFA Cups. This man has won everything that there is to win in English football, which yeah. is fantastic, as well as winning England international. But there's Lee Sharp, a striker, Louis Saha, Jesper Blomqvist, Ronnie Johnson, all people have won European Cups. So they come here, and that was then. Of course it's a spectacle, and of course it's played in the best interest. But be assured, they want to win.
Well,
both sides will want to win.
Well, that's what I was saying earlier.
We were talking before.
It might be fun and games, but at the end of the day, yeah, there's a lot of integrity in this one, and either side wants to win this.
Do you know,
one.
As long as it's played in a good spirit, and it, you know, and there's not silly fouls or whatever's going on, but it's played all of us, whether we play dominoes or we play football, we want to win.
Absolutely.
That's bred in us.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
This will be no exception. So hopefully it'll be a very, very good game.
That's the play in England. This is Africa.
Mm.
South Africa, for that matter. We are coming to play the only team in Africa that won the Champions League.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know? That's Orlando Pirates.
And that happens to be the goalkeeper that was on the go on 1995 in Abidjan. And I'll still be the goalkeeper this Saturday.
Awesome.
It will be hard for Sarah or Posco to pass through me.
Yeah.
The stability unit, Kevin Lane, Mark Fish, yes. Edward Motella, Dumisani Ngobe. I'm not talking of Mark Batchelor, Jerris Kusana, Mark Strikers, Bruce Ramakadi, Tebu Homo Loye. Name them. But I don't want to reveal our secret.
I heard they've got training sessions as well. Our boys are just gonna come. They're gonna, obviously the last one gets in on Thursday morning, so there won't be time for training sessions because obviously there's gala dinners and that. But be assured, like they're saying.
No, there is no room for excuses now.
No, there's no excuses. See that?
I've got a feeling that there is rivalry happening here. So have you the team? I mean, that is the team that is together that's going to be playing on Saturday.
That's the team.
That is a massive team. And
it?
More to come.
Yeah, because we're to create history. But being the fifth legend to beat Man United legend here in African soil.
Yeah, yeah. So we want to win on African soil.
To make the spirit of our late captain.
Yes.
Yeah, indeed. Who's going to be captaining the side?
Well, at the moment, I don't know. But from the look of things, maybe I might captain the team.
Well, you should.
I think so, too. Yeah. I think so, too. So we're still waiting to see who's going to be captaining.
Exactly.
Who will be captaining the Man United team?
Well, that's up to Viv Anderson. He's the team manager. I would think it would probably be Paul Scholes.
Okay, all right, so we'll wait to see on that one. In terms of, I know you say the team arrives and it's gala dinners and publicity events, but, you know, for those South Africans that can't get down to Ellis Park on Saturday, I mean, can they catch the legend somewhere else? So is there anywhere else that we can go out and see them?
There is. I mean, the tickets are for sale on CompuTicket, but there are gala dinners. There's one at the Maslow. There's something happening, a gala dinner at Sun City.
Okay.
There's a golf day. Them sort of things are happening.
Yeah.
We're hoping to do a signing session. We're trying to organise that today. But it's just, he was talking about tickets before. The tickets at this moment in time was quite worrying because we was thinking, well, there's not many sold.
Yeah.
But I was assured today and last night. But they said, listen, as soon as the boys start landing, it's going to take off. So it'd be fantastic.
Yeah.
It would be a great... But is there anywhere else to watch it? Not at this moment in time.
Okay.
Because obviously the Bafana game's on, isn't it?
What were the ticket sales looking like when you last looked?
Yeah, they was looking good. But it's not as good as what we're saying as the 30,000.
Yeah.
That's for sure. But I think we're trying to put the Bafana game on at Ellis Park live so that they can come. The gates would open at 1 o'clock, watch the Bafana game, make a family day of it, and then obviously watch our game.
Yeah. All right, so go to CompuTicket. You'll be able to book your tickets there. You know, one thing about South Africans, we leave it to the last minute.
So I've heard.
It is one of the worst traits that we have. It's like you sort of look and you think, oh, we're not going to do well, and then suddenly you're overbooked and oversubscribed, and then there's just too many people that turn out. But try and book in advance, South Africa. Let's get those ticket sales going.
Gates are open on the day as well, so you can pay at the ground.
Okay.
So it's either way, yeah.
Yeah, so it's a good one. Last year's match, I mean, that took place. Talk to me about that. I mean, that must have been a fantastic moment as well to be playing in with the Legends.
Do you know what? What surprised us all is when you go around and you play games around the world, unless they're really, you know, you're going to play Real Madrid or someone, you don't get the sort of crowds. So when we came here, we was expecting maybe 5,000, whatever. So the boys came over, went out a couple of nights to have a couple of drinks, and then they got to the ground.
Yeah.
There was 32,000. We could not believe it. So that's what, you know, when people come out to support a side like that and from a country like South Africa, then you have to come back because they deserve it because of they were fanatics, Liverpool fans, and we're hoping that they're the same for Manchester United.
You take this around the world, though. It's amazing that this is happening 2 years in a row. But this is something that travels around the world, this Legends, the Legends matches?
Yeah, yeah. We're FC Tours and we've got games in Cyprus, Ireland, already sorted out. We're going to the Middle East, the UAE. Then we're looking at Australia, Singapore. So we're taking this throughout the world, and the boys, like, I mean, all players, even when you've finished professionally, you still want to put a pair of boots on, don't you? You still want to play that football. You get the buzz, and it's showing great interest all around the world. So for us, it was a good time to start a company.
Yeah, fantastic. So, okay, Pirates. So you got the nation behind you as well. There's a lot resting on your shoulders, but you're confident you can take this one. You've looked at the team. You look at who we've got. Is South Africa going to take this one?
Wanted for sure. We are here to play for our foreign hero.
Yes.
Okay.
You know, it's not only about friendly game. Now there's something at stake. You know, we want his spirits to be, you know, happy wherever he is.
Mm. Yeah.
Hopefully, come Saturday with the big crowd behind us, we have to welcome our visitors. You know, this is Africa and South Africa for that matter.
Yeah.
It's a country that we welcome you.
Yeah.
Feel at home. Saturday, 3 o'clock, it will be a different ball game. We will fight
6
you.
O'clock.
Okay, 6 o'clock. Sorry.
They're going to start fighting you from 3, though.
No, you know, why I said 3 o'clock, I want to know whether he's alert.
Okay, he's alert. He
said,
I think he's
you know, unfortunately, from 6 o'clock, that's when the Buccaneers, the ghost, comes out to operate.
Do you know what?
Yeah.
I'm glad I'm not playing.
I don't blame
I'm getting
you.
Quite scared listening to him.
I'm talk scared that. I'm sitting here.
I'm telling you, from 6 o'clock, the ghost, you see the ghost, they start operating.
Yeah.
That's when you will see the good, loving people of South Africa coming in numbers to welcome you people and give you food and drink. At the end of the 90 minutes, we exchange our jersey.
Yeah.
When you get back to England, some of them don't know this.
But they will
problem.
Do.
But they will know after Saturday's game.
Welcome it means, oh, you know what?
Look
it
at
means
this.
So much. I can feel the passion.
Can you feel that passion?
Oh, I can.
I know.
Your guys
are going to be leaving like this. They're going to be boarding the planes.
As soon as they
like
start
that.
Arriving, I'm going to tell them this afternoon. And you know what? It's genuine as well. It's not just banter.
It
means.
Do you know
and
William hasn't looked at me during this interview? He has only looked at you.
But
which means that
that's
this
quite
is,
worrying, isn't it?
I'm worried for you.
You see why I'm looking at him.
No, you keep looking at him.
You
don't look at me.
You see the color of the jersey he's wearing.
You've already converted him.
Black.
I love it. Guys. I think you've just filled out the stadium because I think they know, South Africans know what they're in for. I'm reading some of the tweets that are coming through and everyone's loving this. Stembiso Mkhize saying, the spirit of the former players, Orlando Pirates and LFC, well, of course, you being here for them. This is intoxicating. William Okpara, the best ever. So there you go. You've got some great comments coming through. So, CompuTicket is where you book. The tickets cost how much? Do we know?
From 40 rands upwards.
Oh,
yeah.
Come now. 40 rand. We can afford that for great entertainment. It's going to be fantastic. Thank you for being here.
Pleasure.
Thanks for bringing the legends back. And William, good luck.
Thank you.
You keep that for
we
the
need
field.
It. We need
and
it.
You start at 3, but then you put the show on at 6, okay?
Yeah, I just went to pull his leg.
Okay, brilliant. William Okpara talking to us here, and Mark Wright, former LFC and England captain. And of course, William is going to be the goalkeeper for Saturday's upcoming match. It's going to be incredible. All right.